Linear algebra class number 9. In this video we discuss about a theorem. Let us see the statement. The intersection of any two subspaces W1 and W2 of the vector space V of F is also a subspace. Intersection of any two subspaces is again a subspace. You know that in group theory we learn that the intersection of two subgroups is a subgroup. Even in cyclic groups, the intersection of two cyclic groups is a cyclic group. In the ring theory, we learn that the intersection of two ideals is an ideal. Here, the intersection of two subspaces is again a subspace. The concept is same. So here, let us prove this statement. Let V of F be a vector space. V of F be a vector space. And W1, W2 are any two subspaces of V of F. We have to prove that W1 intersection W2 is a subspace. W1 intersection W2 is a subspace of V of F. Right? Since W1, W2 are subspaces of V of F. Since W1, W2 are subspaces of V of F. We know that every subspace contains at least 0 vector of the vector space. Every subspace contains at least 0 vector of the vector space V of F. Which implies as 0 bar belongs to W1 and the same 0 bar belongs to W2. Which implies as 0 bar belongs to W1 intersection W2. Which implies as, it means 0 bar is common element. Intersection means, what is intersection? The set of all common elements. Intersection means the set of all common elements. So 0 bar belongs to W1, 0 bar belongs to W2. Which means 0 bar belongs to W1 intersection W2. Which implies as W1 intersection W2 is non-empty. W1 intersection W2 is non-empty. Now our aim is to show that it is a subspace of V of F. To prove that it is a subspace of V of F, let us state any two elements alpha comma beta belongs to W1 intersection W2. Let us take alpha comma beta belongs to W1 intersection W2. By the definition of intersection, alpha comma beta belongs to W1 and alpha comma beta belongs to W2. Right? Take any two scalars from the field A comma B belongs to capital F and alpha comma beta belongs to W1 and W1 is a subspace of V of F. W1 is a subspace of V of F. We know that every subspace satisfies one condition. For A comma B belongs to F and alpha comma beta belongs to W implies A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1. Let it be equation number 1. Again, take A comma B belongs to F. A comma B belongs to F. And alpha comma beta belongs to W2 because they are common elements for W1 and W2. And W2 is a subspace of V of F. W2 is a subspace of V of F. If W2 is a subspace of V of F, we know that every subspace satisfies this condition, which implies as A alpha plus B beta belongs to W2. Let it be equation number 2. Right, you observe that from equations 1 and 2, we have A comma B belongs to capital F, alpha comma beta belongs to W1 intersection W2 implies as A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1 intersection W2. Observe that. This is the necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty set to be a subspace. A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1 intersection W2 is the necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty set to be a subspace. Therefore, W1 intersection W2 is a subspace. W1 intersection W2 is a subspace of V of F. Therefore, we conclude that the intersection of any two subspaces is again a subspace. The intersection of any two subspaces is again a subspace in the vector space. This completes the proof of the theorem. Observe that.